Hi friends, today I am with the ASUS Chromebook which you have seen earlier. In this video we will talk a little bit more. So first, if you go to the user account here, you can see you can do the multiple sign in. So this is one thing which I haven't shown in the last video. Now coming to this, this is a C423N model. This is a touch screen and this is a full HD display. It is not a HD display. Now coming to this, you guys have asked us that it supports hard disk or not. So currently I am having a 2 TB hard disk and here I have connected that, and you can see the pop-up on the right side bottom end. So once you see the pop-up, you can go directly to the folders. Here you can see it shows the show the files. You can go from here also, go directly, you can see the files, all your files and folder will be there. Definitely some of the codecs will not support, but Vlc is by default inside it, it will support it. Here you can see I'm just putting the pen drive. You guys have also asked to put the pen drive and try to check that. So here you can see I will also press the open files. Here I am gone. Inside that I have few files. I will play them and show you how to play that in a Vlc player. Just right tap on the click and open with, in that you just change into Vlc player and it works very smoothly. There is no issue regarding playing it. Even it is, this is a touch screen model. I repeat it once again, the C423N model, this is a full HD model. So don't get confused. There is a C423 normal one, which is a HD one. This is not the HD, this is a full HD one. So the lot of confusion was there. So I have shown that the hard disk is definitely can be used in this laptop and also the pen drive can be used. Now coming to the micro SD card, I have also tried that also. It was working quite fine. So there is no issue. Here you can see I am playing another video, and in this video also you can see it plays very smoothly. And this is the video what I am playing through is through the hard disk. Earlier the video what I played, it was from my pen drive. So here you can see it supports full HD. I repeat once again, it supports full HD. The pixel resolution is 1920x1080p. So this is the pixel resolution what you get with this display. It is definitely very vibrant. Coming to the screen, it has a 80% screen to body ratio, 16.1 mm. You can see the width from the side. Here you can see the settings of the Vlc. This is a proper Vlc which can play your media files, so don't worry for that. It will play the Vlc. It has also subtitles, you can add them if you have a subtitle file with them. So it works completely like a normal laptop, so you will not face any issue. Even I am showing you the touch is also working quite fine. Now some of you guys have asked me about the coding in this regarding JavaScript, Python and other few more Linux. So definitely you can do the Linux, but you can't do Python or Java directly, the JavaScript. You have to go through some third party. So this is something you should know, that coding might be a little bit difficult if you go directly. You can install the apps directly. What I have told you here is my files. If you go to the my files, you can see the hard disk and also the pen drive already inserted, and you can take them out by just unplugging. And here you can see the eject button. Just press the eject button and both the pen drive and the hard disk are ejected now, and it works very easily. There is nothing that it has a 2 USB 3.1 and also 1 Type-C port for using your normal data transfer. There is another Type-C port for charging. So there is 2 Type-C port, in which one is a charging port and there is for your normal users, for a pen drive or anything. And there you can also attach printer with this. Coming to the micro SD cards, I have also a micro SD and I will show you the demo. I will plug it inside that. And even in the laptop, you don't need any drivers to play this. It plays normally. So for playing USB or maybe hard disk or maybe a micro SD card, it doesn't take much time. It reads instantly, and the micro SD card goes inside it. You have to press it a little harder. Once it is done, here you can see the pop-up is there and it already have been showing me all the contents, and I am just playing the content directly from the micro SD card. So here you can see how it works, and even you can change the brightness using the touch screen. You can also change the volume control. So there are a few features what you can do using the micro SD card and even in the VLC player. So basically this is the VLC player feature what is offering in the Chromebook. Now if you want to put any command or double click, you just have to put two fingers on the place and there is open with, and open with you can go directly and then you can play the video or anything. It is very easy, it doesn't take much time, and you can learn few things. And I am definitely not the pro, but I am using from some days, and definitely Chromebook is first thing that I would recommend you if you looking for a budget laptop. Here you see that I just ejected the my micro SD card. Now coming to the Netflix, few of you have asked how is the Netflix working. So the best thing is that the Netflix is working fine. It supports full HD video, and also it will let you to download the movies, which is available only in your mobile phone. But the Netflix download is not available in your Windows laptop or your MacBook OS. Now currently the Netflix app is thinking that this is a mobile player, and because it is downloaded from the Google Play Store, it is behaving like the same thing. So you can download the videos directly in the Netflix. Here you can see the download button. I haven't tried that because I know it can download it because the button is there. The interface is quite different. It is not the TV interface, and also it is not the laptop interface what you see with the Netflix. Even I will show you, you have the same thing coming with the Prime also. In the Amazon Prime also you can download the video and save the video for the offline viewing. So this is also something very good. Here you can see I'm just showing you that also. So currently I will show you with finger because some of you think still this is not a touch screen. This is a complete touch screen. Here you can see I just started Amazon Prime. In that I will go. Let's go to the Young Sheldon. And here you can see on the right side there is a download option of complete season 4. So you can download very easily. Coming to this, we get one more conclusion that any OTT platform which lets you to download the videos, you can do the same on the Chromebook OS. Some of you have also asked that the Office will run or not, how will you run the Office. So currently I have downloaded a doc file and it will open directly with Google Docs here. And also it can work with Google Sheets. Even you can download the Microsoft Office app. I will show you that also, how to open in that and how it works. It is very easy. So currently you can see I am just trying to hold with two fingers so that I get the option menu, and from that I can go directly to the Office. And here you can see I am opening in Office. If you have an account of Office or subscription of Office, it will go directly. This is a first time setup. You can see that it will take some time for loading. Once the setup is done first time, then you can go inside. But the part is, if you are not subscribed, you can't edit in it, you can't do the changes. But in Google Docs, you can do the minor changes, whatever changes you need, you can do that very easily, even also in the Google Sheet. So that is advantage. If you have a Microsoft Office account, I will definitely recommend you to sign in, and you can do all the things and get a full-fledged Office in your Chromebook. Now, some of you have also asked that does it support wireless mouse and wireless keyboard. So I don't have a wireless keyboard right now with me, but I do have a wireless mouse, and I will show you how it works. You just have to put the adapter USB inside the USB port of your Chromebook, and then the mouse will run easily. There is no driver needed to install. Here you can see I have done that, and I also have to switch on the mouse also from the bottom part here. Now you can see the cursor on the screen, and it works like a normal mouse what we have seen in the Windows laptop. And you can even do the right click, you can do the changes whatever you need, and it works very smoothly. Even you can see the scroll also works. And I do think that the wireless keyboard will work. And also if you talk about me to the about printer, yes, the printer will work too. So the questions what you have regarding mouse, keyboard and printer, all the external input and output devices, it will support like a normal laptop. Currently you can see I have pinned down the files app and go directly to the files. It shows your entire file system. Currently it has a 64GB internal storage, 4GB is the RAM. You can't expand the memory, it is eMMC. Some of you have also asked about the Free Fire. Now I will show you the Free Fire. The graphics is on ultra, the high-res is on high, and I'm just showing you this. So this is what we are getting in the display for Free Fire. So you can definitely play Free Fire. But one thing to be noted is that the keyboard doesn't work. It is still not compatible. You can play with your touch screen. It has a touch screen, as I already told you. Might be it can support the game controller. So you have to purchase a game controller separately. But without game controller, it will be a little bit difficult to play the game. I tried to play the game. This is not a gaming review, but I showed you because some of you guys have asked me that does Free Fire work on this Chromebook or not. Now, this is actually a challenge for the game developers, Google, and also the laptop manufacturers, who will encourage more developers to bring out the games, apps and develop for this platform so that you guys can have more fun. Currently, you can play the game with the touchscreen. It was a little bit difficult using a mouse pad. Maybe a mouse or a gamepad will be much more easier to play with. So I have tried to answer all your questions in the comment section and also tried to make in this video and cover each and everything. So this is Vivin signing off. Please like the video, share the video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button below for us and keep watching the gameplay. Battle Royale.